Okay guys, today I am going to show you how to make your own little LPS table. Okay, so what you're going to need is a pair of scissors, a pin for marking, 12 beads, whichever color you'd like, 3 jumbo popsicle sticks, a ruler, and foam, whatever color you would like. Okay, so first off, what we're going to do... Oh, you also need a hot glue gun. Never use a hot glue gun by yourself. Always ask your parents to help you or make sure you definitely get permission first. So what we'll do first is we're going to put the 3 jumbo popsicle sticks together and we're going to hot glue them together and then we'll cut them to whatever length you would like your table to be. Okay, so you don't need a whole lot. You want to try to use as little as possible so that it doesn't ooze out of the creases. Like that. With hot glue, if you let it cool off just a tad but not dry all the way, you can wipe it off. I think I did it on the bottom of this table, but it doesn't look like I did. But if you just give it a little bit of time to cool, usually you can just wipe any excess off. That way it doesn't show. But we're going to put foam on top of the desk or table, so it won't really matter. Alright, so let's go ahead and super glue this, or hot glue this third piece on here. Also, if you don't have a hot glue gun, I just got back not too long ago from Walmart, and they have mini ones. There was a mini pink one I saw that was like $2.40-something. That actually would work perfect for something like this. I have a bigger one, but I also do a little bit bigger projects than this. So, but the mini ones would be perfect for furniture and whatnot for your LPS. Okay, so now that we got those glued together, what we're going to do is mark on each side to cut. So, let's see, my red table is about this big, so we'll do this one, we'll make this one a little more smaller. Okay, so what you're going to do is take your ruler and try to get as straight as possible and just mark where you want to cut. Oh, my camera's not focusing. I don't know if you, oh, I guess you can see it. Hold on. Oh, my camera decided not to focus anymore. Or not. Sorry, guys. Alright, so we're going to do this one smaller. Okay, so this one that I'm doing is quite a bit smaller. It's about half of my red one. Okay, so what we're going to do is you just take scissors and cut along your lines. Yes, sometimes the wood does split. That's no big deal. Just do it again. Always be very careful while using scissors. You could, if you would like to, take a nail file and file these. Oh, I just got my beads everywhere. File these edges. They do get rough and you could possibly get a splinter. And the corners do get pretty sharp. You can always file those down to where you won't get splinters because no one wants a splinter. I don't have a nail file right now, so I'm not going to do that. All right, so let's cut the other side. I don't know why my camera won't focus. Pieces just came off. I must not have used enough glue on it, so we're going to go ahead and glue that back real quick. Wow, this one's not wanting to stay. Alright, so now that we got this together, we're going to go ahead and take our piece of foam. I'm going to cut some of this off so I don't have as much. We're going to take some of our foam and glue this on here. So what I do, some people sometimes like will cut out the piece and then glue it. I just like to put glue on the wood and then stick it on and hold it on there. And that way it'll give it some time to dry and then we can cut it. And then while that's drying, we will work on the legs of the table. So I'm going to go ahead and put some glue on here. I choose a side that has the less bumps, so this side's more smooth and this side can be the bottom. Make sure you get the edges as good as you can, that way the foam sticks on the edges. So we're going to put that there and hold it. You don't have to worry about like some of it squeezed out on the edge. You don't have to worry about that because we're going to cut it off anyway. So, alright, so while that's glued, we're going to work on the beads. You're going to need 12 of them. They're going to be the legs. I like to have mine short enough that my LPS are kind of right there. instead of it being too tall or too short. So basically with the beads, all you're going to do is super glue 3 beads together. You're going to try to want to make them as straight as possible. That way your table doesn't wiggle or anything like that. So I'm going to show you how to do it once. Be very careful doing this. Oh, my camera's not focusing again. You want to be very careful doing this because if you get this hot glue on you, it is not going to feel good. Okay, so, ouch, that was hot. I got one done. You can kind of pull off all that extra you have. Sorry, guys, I don't know why my camera's not. There we go. Okay, so I got 3. You're going to want to do this 4 times. So you're going to want to have 1, 2, 3, 4 for each corner. So I will be right back and have those done, and then we'll move on to the next step. Okay, so I'm back and done with the legs, so we're going to set those aside. Okay, so now, well, those fell over. So now what we're going to do is cut out the fold around the leg. So, oh no. So, I was trying to avoid using this piece of foam yesterday because it had these weird marks on it. I guess probably from hot glue. And I guess I grabbed it, so... Okay, so the next step is also the last step, and we are going to hot glue the legs on. So what you're going to do is put hot glue on each corner and glue the legs, and then you'll be done. So let's do that, and that is the last step. So here, hot glue. I don't know why I turned it into a square, so it doesn't really matter which side I start on. There's 1, there's 2. There's a piece that doesn't... There we go. Okay, so you can leave it like this for a little bit to let it fully dry. Or you can be like me, flip it over as soon as you can. Okay, so we have 2 tables. One big, one small. Like I said, you can do whatever length you would like. Doesn't really matter. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed. This was my first video, so feel free to criticize me, and there will be plenty more where this one came from. So let me know what you thought in the comments, and give me ideas of more stuff to make. Alright, have a good day!